You know, once you wake up, once you really, really, really wake up, once you're fully awake, wide awake, you'll realize that everything that comes out of the mouth of singers, artwork, clothing, fashion, all of it, is produced by a spirit through a host body system called a human being. And a human being is a trap for an angel that got caught in a snare, and he's trapped in a transmutation process with his own evil reflection doppelganger. And if he doesn't get converted before that host body dies, then his essence goes into a place that is literally a magnetic prison, because his energy has to go whatever direction it's polarized to. And if it's polarized to evil and hasn't been converted, it will go to that location, which is in the pit. And in the pit, that energy is used to create another locust. That is, you know, the most mind-destroying, mind-melting reality. And let me tell you something. If you don't believe me, just look at your screen on you now. And the Lord has proven it. He's given me absolute proof in the scriptures, using the word of God in tandem with an absolutely mind-destroying supernatural gift. Gift of knowledge, gift of wisdom, gift of discernment. One time I prayed, I said, Lord, what part of the body am I? It says we're all part of the body of Christ. And he told me to open a book, and of course it said the eyes. That's why I had a vision company called Vampire Sunglasses. So tonight's program is going to be one of those programs where it's probably going to raise the hair on the back of your neck a lot, because, well, you know, I'm just going to say it. Look, when the Lord delivers or wants to deliver information to me, do y'all believe now that he has no problem getting it to me as a conduit? Yeah, have y'all seen enough now that you know there's no doubt that he delivers the most profound information on the planet right through this ministry? I mean, you know, it's not me, guys. It's not me. I can't figure this stuff out. Y'all, how many of you guys saw... How many of you guys saw the Vatican that had the Sistine Chapel? I remember when I saw that one, I was so blown away, because it had the moat in the eye of the dragon, and it also had the beam in the eye of the dragon. It was so mind-boggling. I almost couldn't believe what I was looking at. When he showed it to me, it was hard to wrap my brain around it. It was so unbelievable, you know. And where did it go to, though? So my point is, where did that information lead to? It led to the Bible. So he first revealed that the wall was, you know, this giant face of a dragon. Dave, can you write in the chat room, does anybody know what folder that one's in? I've got all these. Just, I'll try the Dragon Church of St. Mary's. Anyway, but there it is. So yeah, here we go. So to be able to see a wall that's painted as a mural, and here it is, it's St. Mary's Dragon Image P. I'm going to put it on your screen right now. And for that to be in the Bible, that's in the Bible, guys. What you're looking at is, you're looking at a biblical revelation of just mind-destroying proportions. That's a dragon. Can all y'all see that's the face of a dragon? Is it easy for y'all to see the face of the dragon? Can y'all see that? You know, there's one eye right there. There's the other eye. There's the nose. There's Lucifer with the virgin coming through the archway. Here's the open mouth of the dragon. There's the chin of the dragon. You know, this area is the open mouth. Here's the lip coming together. It also is a birthing event, water coming through, birthing into the kingdom. I mean, it's just mind-boggling. And to think that led to the Bible, though. See, I want to make sure y'all understand that the image wasn't just a revelation of an image. This went to the Bible, and the Lord took me to Matthew 7, I believe, where it said, you know, why dost thou beholdest the mote or that is in thy brother's eye when there is a beam in your own? And showing the condition of every human being. Here's a mote, a twig, and there's a beam going up. And the beam is going up on top of the line of the tribe of Judah. I mean, that's just mind destroying. I mean, that in that on its own, what you're looking at right there is one of the biggest revelations on the planet. I mean, it doesn't get any bigger. I'll show it to you. There it is. So there it is. I mean, there's the beam going up. There's the mote falling down. The word mote means to dry and wither, to fade away, like that cross means twig. If the cross is falling down, the beam's being erected, and the beam's being erected on top of an image of a lion. I just want to share that to you again, because when I saw it, I was just like, oh my Lord. Y'all see that lion right there? I turned it upside down so you could see it very easily. You see the lion? Okay, so when you're here at this ministry, the gift isn't just someone saying, hey, look at these pictures. This is showing you what the meaning of the mote and the beam in Matthew 7 is. How would you ever know the truth? I've heard preachers preach on that repetitively, and they have absolutely no clue what it is. What you're looking at is, I turn that upside down, so I'll go back the other way. Uh-oh. I don't know what happened there. See if I can get that back. There we go. And they are putting the beam on top of the line of the tribe of Judah. They're killing him for the dragon's government. You see how they're, Lucifer's angels are putting up a beam to support the other eye. Because now you know why the Bible says, if your eye be single, the whole body is full of light. Because your eye is not single, your eye is double. One eye has a beam going up, and one eye has a mote in it that's falling right here. Here's your condition, right? Those are your eyes. Those are your eyes right there. One that's got to be a mote, a twig falling, and the other one's being erected right on top of the lion of the tribe of Judah. I mean, that is absolutely insane. Who in the world could see that? Not me. The Lord can, though. Lord sees everything. And that's what he's doing. Let's take one more little picture I want to look at one of these that's kind of colored in. I remember when he told me to draw on the lines, I was like, can y'all tell I took a Sharpie marker right there? He told me to block in the changes of shadow. And as I blocked in the changes of shadow, y'all see that dragon? Can you imagine what it would be like to be drawing in all the changes of shadow, and you're sitting there going, why am I doing this? And the Lord told me to do it. And then all of a sudden you're looking at the entire Sistine Chapel wall is a big freaking dragon. And then it leads you to the parable or the description of the moat and the beam, because there's a mote in one eye and a beam in the other. And when you reduce it in size, it's easier to see, really, isn't it? can see that dragon. Yeah. So anyway, so I wanted to kind of go over a little bit of that before we get started tonight, because, yeah, the bomb I have to drop is going to be a huge bomb tonight. We're getting very close to, the end of our faith. What I mean by that is we will be more than likely, we will all have an aha moment. Let me back up. Let me just do it to you like this. Do y'all remember when they left Egypt? Everybody know the story of the Exodus? Has everybody read the story of the Exodus, you know, where they left Egypt? Well, you know, they were all excited about getting to go. You know, they were all excited about getting to leave Egypt. They had been slaves for over 400 years. Everybody's like, let's get out of here. Moses came back. He led them out of bondage. You know, that's where Passover comes from. When they had the Passover, where they killed the lamb that was without blemish, which was a foreshadowing of Jesus. It was a foreshadowing of the coming of Christ, because they killed a lamb that was without spot, and they put the blood over the doorpost, kind of like the blood, the way the little head symbols are on this house that I'm living in. They put it on the doorpost, the two vertical doorposts, and over the top of the door, the lintel, and it makes a head symbol. It makes a red head symbol on every door, that every household that got to leave Egypt, okay? The angel of the Lord, death and destruction, would pass over whoever was in that house. Do you understand? Okay, now listen, because this is huge. When, pretend you're back in ancient Egypt and you're one of those Israelites. And you're like, oh, you know, we're finally leaving. You know, all you've known is bondage. You were born into bondage. Because if you were that group that was leaving, you were born there. You were born into that bondage. You were born as a slave. You lived your entire life as a slave. And so then this guy Moses, which means of the water, which was a prince of Egypt, he turns out he was really an Israelite that had been saved on faith. And then he comes back and he leads everybody out because he's God's chosen instrument in order to lead his people out of bondage. Okay, I want everyone to pay really close attention now, because I want everybody to participate. Please answer the question as quickly as you can in the chat room. If you're in the chat room, participate, please. Okay, so whatever chat room you're in, please participate. So anyway, so here's all these prisoners. They're all slaves, which is the same as our condition. We're all prisoners. We're all slaves. But way back then, everybody's going to get to leave, right? Okay, now listen. Wasn't everybody cheering and woo-hoo, yay, Moses, yay. We're all leaving. Moses, let us out. Kind of like a lot of people are going, yay, Jonathan showed us, you know, the truth, and yeah, he's, you know, revealed all this information. Woo! And everybody's all, yay, yeah, yip, 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 yay, yay. Well, let me tell you something. It was all great right up until they got to the Red Sea. Because the Red Sea was their moment of testing for all of them. Because the entire nation of Israel, the entire group that, quote, got to leave, they were all standing there at the Red Sea. They were at Migdol by the sea, by Pi-Hiron and Baal-Zephon. By the way, if you look at the meanings of all the words of all the places where they were camped, it's all extremely significant. Every definition of every word. I did a study on it years ago. It's mind-boggling. But anyway, so there they are. There's everybody that was, yoo-hoo-hoo, yay, yay. And now everyone's like, oh, crap, here we are at the Red Sea. And then all of a sudden, everybody was like, oh, let's, you know, kill Moses. He brought us out here. it would have been better to die as slaves in Egypt. That's what they said. Because they wussed out. They chickened out. And the reason they chickened out is because their faith wasn't really in God. And they, you know, this is where they got their test. And what was their test? Everybody, anybody know what their test was? When did everybody start crawfishing? You know, y'all know what crawfishing means? Here in Texas, y'all know what a crawfish is. It starts moving backwards really fast. It starts backpedaling really quick. So you're gonna figure this out in a minute. So where did everybody start freaking out? What was the event that precipitated everybody freaking out? I'll tell you what it was. When they saw that they might die. Oh, you mean when here comes an overwhelming horde of guys on chariots and an army coming at them, and they were trapped. There was nowhere to go, was there? Oh, no. And here comes Pharaoh's army. And now it's time where this is where the rubber meets the road, guys. This is where you find out who's who, whose faith is real, whose faith is just BS. Who's just going along with it? Who's saying, oh, yeah, praise God. They don't really mean it. That's right. Ryan Z already wrote it, like locusts from the pit for us. That's right. Let me tell you something. Everybody was great right up until here it comes. Here it comes. Okay, well, then what happened? Then Moses went out. He prayed. And he said, Lord, you know, fight for us. And the Lord told Moses, be still and look up. I'm telling you, everything I'm telling you right now is going to foreshadow what's going to happen. I bet you $1 million. Do I know it for sure? No, but I'll bet you $1 million. Okay, so anyway, so back then, way back then, everyone that had the head symbol on their house, remember the big red head symbol with the blood of the lamb without spot or blemish, okay, they were covered in the blood, so the angel of death passed them over, and then they left, and they got to the Red Sea. But, uh-oh, here comes Pharaoh's army. Everybody freak out, right? And Moses said to stand still. He told Moses, stand still and look up, and you'll see the salvation of the Lord. Oh, look, Alyssa even put it in there for you. For the Egyptians whom you have seen today, you shall see them again no more. Or forever. Okay, so now here's the thing. Let me ask you a question. Y'all know that I have three head symbols on this house, don't you? Y'all know that this house I'm in is extremely supernatural, don't you? Y'all know that everything about this house that was given to me is a repayment for two other houses that were just basically, well, stolen from me. Right, that was someone's trying to clear their conscience. So they thought they'd, you know, hang on to about $300,000 and say, here, let me give you a house that I bought for $60,000 that is a complete and utter dump, and I'm going to give this to you to get off. By the way, when I say give it to me, it is not in my name either. I just want you to know that. The house that I'm living in, it's the same old story as the last two houses. It was given to me, but it's not in my name. It's really fascinating. I don't care if it's in my name, because it doesn't matter for me. I'm not here to hold on to something in this world. But this house is a representation of what's been given back to us, and that's a temple that's been restored, because this house represents a restored temple. Y'all understand that? And on this house, it has three head symbols, and that's 888, and that is in gematria. It is Jesus. It literally, on the house is written Jesus, not just in a head symbol, but in a red head symbol, and not just in a red head symbol, but a red head symbol made out of clay bricks. When the bricks around them are made out of metal, and they have a metal content. So that's insane, like metal mixed with miry clay. So the house I'm in is as supernatural as it gets. It is absolutely an outward manifestation of what the Lord God is doing. So here's the point. So the guy that's talking to you right now, that is sitting in this house, was used to help restore the house, and that's what I've been doing, is trying to restore God's temple, which is the body of believers, because I've been giving you all the information the Lord God gives me. And when God gives me something, I try and get it to you as quickly and the best I know how to do it. And I try and just give you what he gives me and say, here you go. This is what the Lord God gave me. And I am a purveyor of information. I just give it out. Here it is. Here it is. Here it is. I'm a conduit, not a purveyor, a conduit. Okay, so now I'm here to tell you, and I'm here to tell you. I mean, you're looking at, look at your screen on you now. Look at that. Y'all see the Vatican? That is a big serpent, isn't it? I mean, everybody knows that that's a giant serpent wearing a crown, don't you? Okay, well, it is. So if I'm able to show you all these things, like this image right here, is the entire Vatican a dragon coming up out of the sea? It's a yes or no answer. It's on your screen right now. Is that image of the Vatican a dragon wearing a crown coming up out of the sea? Yes or no? Yeah. Okay. Was the wall of the Sistine Chapel a giant dragon? It's a yes or no answer. It is, right? Okay, is the entire Vatican itself, the entire building, is it a giant serpent wearing a crown? It's a yes or no answer. Is the largest altar in the world, that's the mouth of that serpent, is it a big dead sheep? It's a yes or no answer. It is. Is that big dead sheep, when you turn it upside down, is it the female reproductive system? It's a yes or no answer. Right. Don't worry, guys. I'm getting to a very serious point. We're gonna have a moment tonight of reality, and I'm trying to make sure that everybody understands. Just like the Egyptians, they got to see a moment of, you know, they got to see a moment of their entire belief system, whether or not they really believed God was going to deliver them out of bondage, and where, you know, what was their mental and spiritual disposition right there at the Red Sea. They got to find out who they were. Everybody was made manifest. I guarantee you, every single person, no matter what, had to have some kind of an emotional response and a mental response to that army coming at them. And it was probably, you know, it was probably overwhelming. And I wasn't there. So I can't say, you know, I can't say a word, because I may have been the biggest, you know, I may have had on my Cowardly Lion costume. And, you know, I can't say, who knows? I wasn't there. I can tell you something for sure. What you're looking at on your screen right now, if you're watching you now, is a human in a slave collar that has been turned upside down. And that very image turns into a locust coming out of the pit. Now, let me ask you, everybody, do you understand that that's what that is? Do you understand what you're looking at? Do you know that that is definitely a locust from the pit? Do you get that? You understand that? So you have to realize that if you're looking at a locust from the pit, then I was meant to be the servant that revealed it, because I'm revealing it. Do you understand? What I mean is, somebody had to be the person to reveal what was coming. Why? Why would God make sure that the population at large would have this information available to them? What would be God's reasoning to show all of y'all that there is this thing that's coming out of a pit that's a locust. Why would he do that? I'm looking at, I'll tell you why he did it. So when you see it, you will have the faith to stand and not run. It's probably going to be like 10 times more horrific than anything you've ever seen. I went to see the new Alien movie called Alien Covenant. And before I went to the movie, the Lord God just grabbed a hold of me. And, you know, the way he leads me sometimes, I can't really explain to you how he does it. He just does it. And before I even went to the movies, he was showing me things before the movies that he wanted me to see. So when I went to the movie, I would understand. I would understand what I was looking at. Because I'm here to tell you, I think I can say with pretty much $1 million bet assurity that we are going to have a Red Sea moment for all of us. And I'm trying to make sure you understand that. I don't want to see all this, oh, praise God, oh, I love you, Jesus, all that stuff, and you not really have faith. You know what I mean? Because let me tell you something. If you're here at this ministry and you've seen the kind of information that's been delivered here, you know, you were given this information for a reason. It wasn't just so you could say, praise God. It was to prepare you. It was to get you ready. Because what you're probably going to see, let me tell you what the Bible says. Men's hearts will fail them for fear. Now, I'll tell you what. I've seen a lot of scary movies in my life, and I've seen plenty of scary movies. Among the scariest of these movies were the Alien series with Sigourney Weaver. And I'm telling you that what I've seen and what I'm being shown is it's that kind of a level of stuff. And I want to show you the outward manifestation of this just right in front of your face. I'm going to click on another link. I want y'all to go to the clothing link because we're going to talk about this. I'm trying to make sure y'all are ready. I'm going to click on clothing part four, okay? Clothing part four. I think that's the one I'm looking for. Hang on one sec. No, maybe it's part three. Just give me one second. Uh-oh. Hang on one sec. Let's try clothing part three. I want to show you the obviousness of the manifestation of what's going on. And let me see if I got it. Dave, the wave, I may have to call on you to tell me. Dave, the skateboard decks that had... Dave, the skateboard decks that had the girl with the scorpion face. I thought it was in part four. Let me try part four again. Yeah, part four. There it is. Okay, y'all give me one second. So I want to show you something because I'm seeing this outward manifestation to a degree that I've never seen it before. And it's gonna get real. There it is. Okay, let me show you something. There we go. I want y'all to look in the middle of your screen right now. Y'all see this right here? This is one of the most telling pieces of art on a skateboard. It's so perfect. See, it's a woman's mouth and a woman's eyes, but what it really is a scorpion from the pit. Because you know, the artwork that I've done, and by the way, I see Billy Lozak is in the chat room, and you know, Billy's in the you now chat room. Let me tell you something, and I am not exaggerating. Exaggerating is a form of lying, by the way. In my art room, where I carved the mystery of all things before I ever got saved, I carved it into metal using light as my medium because the Lord obviously was guiding me. I have images of locusts coming out of the pit, and they're coming out of this wall and this vortex. And what's on the front of the wall are all these really attractive women with, you know, hot bodies that, you know, like we're talking, you know, I carve like women with really perfect bodies and stuff like that on the front wall. And then behind the wall coming out of the pit are the locusts, because the women were the bait for God's angels. That's the whole host body system was. See, Billy Lozak wrote in the chat room, true. Okay, now here's the thing. Don't you think that if everything else that is in my artwork in the house and everything that's prophetic, all of it is, don't you think if all of it has been so far, don't you think the rest of it's going to be for sure? I mean, you know the way God does something. You don't think that he would let me do all that artwork that's so perfect and it's so right on the money, then all of a sudden, when we get to the end of the world and we get to that final big day, do you think that he would really not let it be like a home run? I don't believe that for a second. Now I'm going to go back to the locust coming out of the pit from the Vatican. Now we're going to go to tonight's show notes in just a minute. And I'm going to tie some stuff together for you because it is very disturbing. I'll be honest. I have cried today I have probably cried four times pretty good, you know, where I just put my hands over my face and just started crying because I know I'm the messenger that gets to deliver this brutal information. And I know how real it is. And I know that I'm the conduit. And I know that I'm the guy that's bringing news that is so mind-destroying that most people, you know, can't even wrap their brains around it. But you have no idea what it's like to be me. I guarantee it. It doesn't matter how close of a friend I have. I will never be able to explain to anybody what it's like to be the guy drawing in the images, knowing what it is, and knowing what's coming for everybody and not being able to stop it. There's nothing I can do. All I can do is warn you. That's it. And so I'm going to warn you. Because when that day comes, the last thing I want from anyone that's part of this ministry, the last thing I want is for any one of y'all not to have known the severity of what's coming. You know, a lot of times I kind of joke around because humor is a way for me to deal with the, you know, the enormous weight of the information because the information is so weighty. So sometimes I'll try and tone it down with a little bit of humor or something, but there's a point to where you need to let everybody know this is no freaking joke. This is as serious as it gets. It doesn't get any scarier. This is the scariest movie ever made times 10. And Jesus even told us it is the greatest horror the world will ever see. And so I'm telling you, when I went to go see this new Alien Covenant movie, the Lord was letting me know this is something you got to prepare people for. And he literally made sure before I went to the movie that he gave me the data points I would need during the movie. And when I saw it, I was like, oh, my Lord. That's why I've had like four or five really good just moments where I just started crying and had to put my hands over my face and just cry because this is so hardcore. This is no joke. This is serious stuff. And what you're looking at in this human in the slave collar, that's everyone's condition that goes into the pit. And everybody becomes food for one of these things and there's no way out of it. So you want to make sure that before that day gets here, you want to make sure that you're ready. You want to make sure, you know, you know the truth and the truth is in you. And so if that moment comes where you're standing at the Red Sea, there is absolutely no escape whatsoever that you do what the Bible told you to do. When that happens, stand and look up. Did y'all know that that's, you know, the Lord told Moses, look up, right? He told him to stand there and look up. Well, in Matthew 24, it says, when you shall see the abomination of desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet, stand in the holy place. Whoso readeth, let him understand. Let them which be in Judea flee into the mountains. It really means to leave. Let him which is on the housetop not come down to take anything out of the house. Neither let them which are in the field return back to take his clothes. For there shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time. And except that those days should be shortened, there should be no flesh saved, but for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened. And what that means is, if you're one of the ones that are the elect, you're not going to go through all those days that everybody else is going to go through. Doesn't the Bible say, I believe it's in Luke 21, men's hearts will fail them for fear of looking after those things which are coming on the earth? Yeah, it says, when these things begin to happen, what does it tell you to do? I want to make sure y'all know what it tells you to do. What does it tell you to do? When you see these things happening, look up. Oh my gosh. It said to do the same thing he told Moses to do. And you're talking to the guy that's got het symbols on his house. Kind of like, remember Moses went in and told everybody, hey, put the blood on your doorpost and over your lintel. Well, Jesus is that blood over us, and we have, you know, metaphorically the same blood over the doorpost. But he made sure that I was living in a house that was an exact representation of what he's talking about, because my house has three head symbols on it that are in red, and they're made out of clay, and it is the name Jesus. In this house, you don't walk in a front door. You go to the right or you go to the left. There is no front door for this house. You go to the right or you go to the left. Don't y'all see what's going on? The Lord's getting us ready. Yeah. He's making sure that you know. Because when we start this next part, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a song on here in a minute. And when we come back, I'm going to show you the way it was delivered to me. I'm going to deliver to you what was delivered to me. And I want y'all to embrace it, because we can trust our God. You know, we have the Bible to see what he's done all the way through. You know, I mean, we've been able to read the stories, and y'all know, y'all, for those of y'all that know the truth, you know that the Bible's true, don't you? Well, the Bible is the word of God. I mean, in the beginning, there was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Word became flesh. So I'm trying to get y'all ready. I don't want anyone to leave this program tonight not knowing that I told you. It may be a lot more than you thought. Because if you see coming, you know, I mean, it says that these things have wings, Revelation 9:11. Well, let me give you a visual. Picture a snow globe, okay? Just picture a snow globe, and then picture in the dead center of the floor of the snow globe. You know, make the snow globe, you know, whatever, the size of your house or something. And in the dead center of the floor of the snow globe, picture a geyser shooting straight up and hitting the top of the globe and then spreading out, you know, engulfing the entire area. You know what I mean? You know what that would look like? It would be like an oil well shooting up, hitting the dome, hitting the firmament, and then it would spread out over the whole thing. Okay, try and imagine that. Try and imagine that with the same creature from the Alien movies, and it's got wings. I'll say it again. Try and imagine that, and what's hitting that firmament and spreading out is the same creature from the Alien movies, but it's got wings, like the xenomorph that's in the Alien movies. That's heavy duty. And let me show you, when we come back, what the Lord showed me so I can kind of get y'all, you know, on the same page. It's, I told you, I've had my hand over my face, repetitively crying today because I know what's coming. Billy Lojack is in your chat room right now, and you know. Billy Lojack has stayed at this house several times. Billy was here to help me level the grounds to get those big blocks in the backyard. And Billy has seen my artwork, and he knows. He'll tell you, those service entry caps that I use for those locust heads coming out of the pit, it's not a coincidence. That was the Lord's doing, guaranteed. Let me tell you something. They literally look identical to the creature from the Alien movies. They're identical. Literally identical. So, you know, the Lord, he doesn't make mistakes. So he's probably making sure that I get everybody ready. Because if you were warned in advance, when it does happen, you'll have the faith to go, I'm going to look up. I'm not going to run. I'm just going to look up. Don't look at them. Just look up. Okay? All right, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get a song out. And then we're going to come back and y'all can get out your show notes from tonight. And let's see. You might want to open up Wikipedia, goddess Nut, N-U-T. The Egyptian goddess Nut, N-U-T, from Wikipedia. It might help you a little bit understand. But anyway, let me get this. There we go. Let me get my screens ready for you guys. There you go. I'm going to get that. I'm going to put what I want y'all to be kind of focusing on. I'm going to put it on your screen right now on YouNow. Those who try and hide their plans, what do? They turn everything what? Upside down. I want you to look at the goddess Nut. Her head's upside down, and I want you to look at the image from the Alien Covenant movie. And I want you to use a little bit of discernment and figure things out while I'm grabbing some water. Okay, y'all ready? I'm going to put on a song. Okay, it's going to be a little bit slow because I've got to change out like points here. So I have to plug in different speakers. Here we go. Just a second. Okay, here we go. Thank you. Okay, hey, listen, I need to look at the chat room for a sec. Hey, Dave the Wave, I got a question for you. Where is the Women's March stuff? Do you know what folder? I looked for it. I couldn't find it. We got so many folders now. There's just so much information. Dave, you know where the Scooby-Doo stuff is? I mean, I just want to show everybody something. It's just mind-boggling. I can't snare too. Yeah, I think you're right. I think it's the snare too. Okay, so guys, I want to show y'all something. First of all, I want y'all to look at the image that's on your screen right now. There's a xenomorph coming out of this guy's chest. I want you to look at, the egg where it's kind of hatching. That's called the face hugger. It leaves the egg, and then it goes and it finds a host, and then it comes out of the host body. It's a race within a race, isn't it? Wow, yeah. A race within a race. Yeah, that's pretty disturbing. Again, what does the largest altar in the world turn into? Let me walk you through this real quick. Okay, I'm gonna walk you through this real quick. Let's start with the basics. Everybody look at you now. Okay, when you turn the virgin upside down, it equals a dead sheep. When you turn Nefertiti upside down from a hieroglyph that has an alien having sex with a human woman, it turns into the queen turns into a dead sheep as well. Now, the largest altar in the world, St. Peter's throne, is a dead sheep, and the dead sheep, when you turn it upside down, is the female reproductive system, and what's going into the female reproductive system are God's children. Yeah, the Bible says, "Have I not said you are gods, angels? But you shall die like men." And when you stand back and you look at that giant altar, probably the most important thing you could know about that altar is what's on your screen right now. What does that altar become when you step back and you look at it when you're walking in the door of the Vatican? What does that, it becomes a giant locust. Correct. So it's a giant bug. It's a locust from the pit. So you got to realize that's the real enemy right there. That is the proverbial man behind the curtain, you know, like the Wizard of Oz. When Toto pulled back the curtain, there is the guy that was back there pulling the levers. The one that's pulling the levers is right there. That's it. That's what's pulling the levers. Right there. That's what's doing it. This is the biggest reveal probably in the history of the world. I mean, the Lord told me I'm going to use you to solve the riddle of ages. And he did. And I'm not just showing you, I'm proving it again and again and again and again. I mean, I can literally prove this repetitively using other venues. I can go use stuff from the Indian culture. I can go to other cultures and prove it out the same way. It all proves out again and again and again. People are husks for those locusts. Correct. That's what the host body system is. It was some really good bait, was used against God's angels. Hey, you want to have sex? You want to have families and everything will be great? And you won't die? Okay, well, try this. And it turned out to be a transmutation trap, a snare where they got caught, turned upside down, and then their food, their souls became food for the locusts in the pit. That's it. That's all there is to it. It's proven. Okay, so now we're gonna get into the reality of what these locusts really are. Okay, but you're seeing a giant altar. There's one. Let's go ahead and look at the guy in the slave collar and what he turns into. When you turn the slave collar guy upside down, he becomes a locust coming out of the pit. It's got very sharp mandibles. It's got wings. It's got claws. And the Bible says it has a sting on its tail, so it's got a tail. Y'all understand? It's got a tail. Okay, so I'm going to go to tonight's show notes, and I'm going to see if we have the trailer from Alien Covenant. We're going to watch the Alien Covenant trailer here. Just sit tight. Okay, guys, y'all just sit tight. We're going to watch Alien Covenant trailer. And then I'm going to go over, after we watch the trailer, then I'm going to go over everything the Lord showed me before I went to the movie. And then after I went to the movie, what he was revealing to me in order to get y'all ready. You know, I don't think it's going to be here tomorrow or anything, to be honest, because I think the shipping container is going to be a must. He told me to do it. He always has purpose in what he does. And the shipping container is coming in next Friday. They will be setting that shipping container down next Friday at 9 a.m. It is scheduled to be put in this backyard behind the house that has the name Jesus on the house itself. Okay, so let's watch this. Let's watch this trailer. Here we go.
You've all sacrificed so much to be here and be a part of this thing we're doing.
This crew is made up of couples.
It's the first ever large-scale colonization mission.
And everyone back on Earth is
really grateful for your hard work and your courage.
We're making history here.
This is wheat. What are the odds of finding human vegetation this far from Earth?
Who planted it? You hear that?
What?
Nothing. No birds. No animals. Nothing. What happened here?
Okay, so now, see, a lot of people don't think of something this severe when you think of locusts from the pit, do you? I mean, be honest, like when I talk about, yeah, locusts are going to come out of the pit, you don't think of an overwhelming horde of something that scary, do you? Well, it's identical to the artwork in my house. So if it's identical to the artwork that I did before I got saved, that is coming out of a portal like the pit. And now listen very carefully. On the front of the wall, the front, I see I have like a bar counter where it's got a front wall to it and then the top, you know. And that front wall, it's got, you know, like I said, attractive women's bodies carved on there, even plasma cut the shapes of their bodies. And on the top, it shows, you know, fornication. And then coming out from behind that wall is where the locusts are coming from. The artwork is prophetic, obviously, because I even carved the same thing as, you know, the gates of hell, Rodan. Somehow I carved the same thing that's on, you know, Rodan, the gates of hell. I mean, before I ever got saved. So, you know, try and wrap your brain around that. Let me show you something. I want to show you guys a very mind-boggling thing. We're gonna start breaking it down now. We're going to start looking at it. We're going to kind of critically look at some stuff. And I'm going to show you, you know, the way this stuff is cryptically put in your face. And it's just the craziest thing ever. But, okay, I'm going to look at the snare folder. So I think in the snare folder should be snare 2. Okay, so in the snare folder. Okay, y'all remember that. The vesica piscis is the intersection of the two sets, like Under Armour, the Under Armour logo. Okay, now let me click on a picture that shows you, look, y'all remember, the vesica piscis is basically what's the prison that started it all, right there, that shape. Y'all understand? That shape right there, the intersection of the two circles, forms that gray area called the vesica, which is the prison. That represents the host body system prison above ground. But what's below ground? You know what I mean? We're trapped in host bodies above ground, but what's below ground? Oh, Apollyon and all the locusts from the pit. That's what's below ground. So let me show you a representation from that host body system above ground and what it means for us to be able to look into, you know, that world. It's going to be very disturbing, but it's so in your face. I want to show everybody some pictures from the Women's March when Trump was campaigning. I want to show everybody that picture. They carried that banner. I looked up the artist. It's just insane. That's a really demonic thing. That's a woman lifting her skirt and the egg that came out, they believe could stop entire armies, a woman lifting her skirt. I mean, but there's a lot of truth to all this stuff. It's really crazy. And if you look right there, you'll see the center of the kelipot. Y'all remember the kelipot? Y'all remember the kelipot? There's the center of it right there. Okay, you see the female reproductive system? And you see the whole thing makes a giant face of a serpent? The whole thing is the head of the serpent. It's a female reproductive system. It shows the egg right here with all this energy going out, and the energy is controlling the 13 people at this board table representing the 13 most powerful families in the world. Okay, you see it? Where is all the energy coming from? It's coming from the egg. Okay, well, I'm showing you outward manifestations of the truth. And then we're going to get into this xenomorph thing. I want to show you guys an absolutely mind-boggling image from the Women's March. Why does that woman have a serpent as the reproductive system? Look right here. You see the serpent? Wow. So that woman, I guarantee you, that host body is one of them. There's no doubt about it. That is like the ones that wink their eyes and stick out their tongue. How did she get that so perfect? I mean, that's just mind destroying. But let me show you where things get very real now. Okay, let me go back to the alien stuff real quick. Let me go over here. Okay, if you're looking at the alien movie, there are these eggs that are the pods. And let me show you what comes out of them. Let's have a look right there. I want y'all to have a look right there. Do you think that they are... Do you think they are manifesting, like, you know, the female reproductive system here? Well, of course they are. Of course they are. And, you know, they're just really intensifying it. And they're making it, you know, just, yeah, really. Well, there's a lot of truth to this whole thing. I mean, so that's what goes on top of someone's face in order to turn them into a host body for the new race that's going to be birthed inside of them. I want you to look at that for a sec. Okay, so, yeah, this is going to get very real in just a second, so just sit tight. So let me go back to the Women's March. Who likes Scooby-Doo? Who likes Scooby-Doo? I do. I love Scooby-Doo. In the Scooby-Doo movie, Spooky Island, Shaggy and Scooby are going through this castle and they get pinned to a wall by a bunch of sausages. See, there's Shaggy and Scooby. They get pinned to the wall by a bunch of sausages. You see Shaggy and Scooby there? Can somebody please tell me what these things are on the wall? Allegedly, they're supposed to be turkeys is what they're supposed to be, because I see a drumstick right there, sort of a drumstick right there, but this is supposed to be a turkey and a turkey and a turkey. Now, let me show you what comes out of that turkey when it opens up. So let's just talk like adults here. That is a vagina. And if you were to put your penis in there, what would be taking it would be what's in there. Do you understand? So the alien movies are very much true, because H.R. Giger, by the way, wanted to know and understand and to connect with what was really running things. And that's how he came up with all his artwork for the movies. That's coming out of the quote alleged turkey breast. Do you understand? So this is as mind destroyingly bizarre as it is rooted in the truth. That is exactly the same thing as the alien movies. I want you to look at it for a sec. That is the same thing as the alien movies. How crazy is that? So now, you know, you're talking to someone that is a conduit of information. All these things that you're looking at originated in the spiritual world. I mean, that right there was where the Matrix began. That's where it all started. That's where the monster came from. It literally is like aliens in Prometheus, Scooby-Doo, the Mummy. That's correct. It's pretty mind-blowing, isn't it? It's hard to wrap your brain around all this sometimes, isn't it? Yeah. It's mind-boggling. It's a portal. Yeah, it's a portal to take the spiritual and turn it into flesh is what it is. It's a way to convert spiritual to flesh. Now do you understand why someone would make a skateboard that's got the eyes of a woman, the mouth of a woman, and it's a scorpion? Because what they're being, you know, what the host body is being used for is to produce that in the pit. And when the pit opens up, that's what's coming out. What's coming out is what's, you know, pretty much in these alien movies. I would venture to say it's probably almost identical. It's going to be hardcore. So anyway, let's get back to the show notes for tonight. Okay, now I want you to look at this image on your screen. This is straight from the Alien Covenant thing. Does that look like Scooby-Doo? Yes or no? Does that look like Scooby-Doo? Doesn't that look identical to the Scooby-Doo thing I just showed you? Of course it does. I mean, that's disturbing. That's right. Yeah. There you go. See, right here, if I was to rotate it towards you this way, if I took this and rotated it back, that's identical to the Scooby-Doo thing. Identical. There it is. You see what I'm saying? Now I'm going to make it very real for you. Okay, now look. I want you guys to look at this. You see right down here? This is in the shape of a foot. You know, like, this is a foot, and that is a hand. Can you tell? They've disguised it a little bit, but that's a foot and a hand. Now look. That's a head. That's an upside down head. That's a buttocks. That's a shoulder. Now, the whole alien agenda comes down under a pyramid like this, and there's a level right here, which is a person in front of the inception leaving the egg, and then it goes down, and it fertilizes the host body, and then out of the host body comes the new race. Does that remind you of anything? How about everything Jonathan Kleck's been teaching us for years? Oh my God, it's exactly what he's been teaching. It's identical. But let me make it real for you. I want to show you guys the goddess Nut in Egyptian theology. Let me show you the goddess Nut in Egyptian theology. Now, you can go read Nut about Nut. She's the goddess of the sky, and then there's the goddess of the earth. And so she rules over the heaven. And then if you read, you know, I could read you all about her, but it doesn't really matter. That's what they're representing here. This is Nut. And below her, see, she's upside down. Look, head, butt, hands, feet. So now we have clearly identified Nut. The Lord let me identify it before I went to see this movie. I was like, oh my Lord, that's Nut. Now let me show you something. Oh, there's the system. There's, you know, one hand's on the vagina, one hand's on her breast, because it comes out of here and it feeds here. But then there's someone laying on the ground, and it looks like a sacrifice, doesn't it? Oh, my Lord God, that is identical to that. Same thing here and here. Now, remember, this is the guy that showed you an alien inside Akhenaten right there. Remember? And his neck turns into a penis impregnating a woman. And so now the system becomes revealed. Now, the whole thing has been revealed to me. Y'all understand now that we're talking about one serious, very mind-destroying reality. And so when you turn the queen upside down, she becomes a dead sheep. There's a sheep's eye, tongue, nose. There's the eye, top of the head, ear, teardrop, nose, tongue sticking out. So now we understand the entire system. The Lord wasn't kidding when he told me I'm going to use you to solve the riddle of all things, of everything. You're looking at it. That's why we're supposed to pray for our enemies, because what's coming for them is absolutely horrifying. Let me show you a picture real quick. See if y'all know what that is. Y'all know what that is? Is that a snake? Y'all know what that is? Anybody know what that is? That's a human. Sure looks like a head of a serpent, doesn't it? Sure looks like the head of a serpent, doesn't it? That's a human fetus. The human host body is the biggest lie ever told. Let me show you another image of a human fetus. Does that look a little bit like an alien? Of course it does. So now we're starting to figure everything out, right? How do you like your iPhone? What do you think a bunch of cavemen thought it up? No. Okay, so now let's get back to the show notes for tonight. Let me move some folders around. Just one moment. I forgot what this is called. This is called a char something. You see this girl winking? A char. I forget what it's called. You see the girl winking? There's a name for this in the. I can't. It's anime, but it's. Got a very specific name for this girl, and look, she's sitting on this guy having sex. Look at her tail. Chimera, thank you. A chimera. Yeah, but look at her tail. Look at her tail. I mean, you know. You see what I mean? The world you think you know is not what you think you know at all. I'm telling you guys, the host body system is the biggest trick there is. Oh, let me show you that this is real. Let me show you how you know it's real. Watch. Well, first of all, the Bible says that out of the pit. What's this girl doing? What's the same one doing? Winking. Yeah. That's it. And you just, you know, we couldn't see what was running things from behind the scenes, but now we can. Now we know what's going on. And let me show you where this is going. That's where it's going. Now, let me get back to the, everybody go back to your show notes from today. Okay, now the Lord's let me prove to you that the Alien Covenant movie is the identical thing as Nut, and it's the same agenda from Egyptian theology, which is the oldest, you know, gods and goddesses, and that's who Moses went up against. Moses went up against the Egyptians, and the night I got saved, how many people remember what the Lord God told me? The blank is your enemy. What did the Lord tell me? The blank is your enemy, Jonathan. What was it? Pyramid. Okay, let's take a look at let's take a look at stuff from the movie. The name of the corporation that's sending everybody out that owns, you know, the artificial intelligence guys that are running the ships, and he also is the money behind the colonization, is the Wayland Corporation. You see it? What do you notice about the Wayland Corporation from the movie Aliens? So now you know. And then what happens with the city of Waco when you turn the city of Waco and their little their W with the star and the crescent moon, what happens when you turn that upside down? It becomes what? What is the Waco logo? 9/11. What, somebody tell me what Revelation 9/11 is? They had a king over them, the angel of the bottomless pit. That's why Islam is such a sick, twisted religion, because it's convert or die, because they are the above ground race. They are directly part of the above ground race. Absolutely. They are the slave race. What do you think about Hagar having, you know, Abraham having sex with Hagar and creating the slave race, right? The Ishmael. Oh, and yeah, and we're children of the free woman. You understand how everything has come together and makes 100% perfect sense now? Oh, yeah. That's why there's a crescent moon and a star. They had a king over them, the angel of the bottomless pit. That's why Islam is such an evil religion. It's straight up evil. Then, you know, you either convert or die. Everyone's an infidel. You know, they believe in look where they go, and they take they set their foot on the soil. They say it's theirs, and then they start raping the women and putting their seed in women they're raping. Does that sound like something we're talking about here? Oh my gosh. All of a sudden, everything makes sense. Yeah, this is some heavy, heavy, heavy duty stuff. So now I want to show you the name of the movie and what's on these guys' jackets right here. USCSS Covenant. And what do you see right here? You see those wings? Y'all see those wings? Where have you seen those wings before? I'll show you where you've seen them. There you go. That's where you've seen those wings before. Let me show you where those wings come from. That's where those wings come from. Oh, Covenant. ISIS. ISIS. See? So let's go back to, let's see. There you go. Covenant. Covenant is, they are coming out of the pit, folks. I guarantee it. Hang on one sec. You ready? I'm gonna force this image into there. Here we go. There you go. There it is. Covenant. Dun, 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 dun. So, if we have all the pieces of the puzzle, and it all goes back to ancient Egypt, do y'all remember what the Lord used to let me unlock this? What did he use to unlock it from ancient Egypt? The hieroglyph. Let me see. Where's the hieroglyph? There we go. Watch this. So here we go. This is the whole story right here. All this is in my house, by the way. Look at this. And I want to show you something really disturbing. Let's see if I can get a close-up on this. The king and the queen and the hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti. The king and the queen are being stung in the back of the neck by a stinger. It's right here. Let me see if I can get a better image real quick. I'm not sure which folder. Hang on one sec. Because I have an image of it where it's very, very clear. And I want to see if I can find it here real quick. Maybe in another folder. Yeah, the king and the queen, the pharaoh and the queen, are both being stung in the back of the neck by a stinger. I'm going to have to go look that one up and find it, but now it all makes sense. Here we go. There's an image. I think I can grab it. There it is. Right there. And it's stinging them in the back of the neck. And it's DNA. So it all fits together now. Everything fits together like a glove. I have this where I actually drew it in, and it is absolutely like a stinger, like a wasp or a scorpion. It's got barbs on it, and it's DNA. So it is absolutely perfect again. So anyway, so now we've got all the pieces to the puzzle, guys. So here's the thing. If I have, you know, in my artwork here in my house, the same exact stuff that is on the, you know, in the movie Alien Covenant. If the movie Alien Covenant has, you know, the twin motif on, you know, on their logo, the Wayland, it's got the two intersecting, you know, V's making twins. And it matches every single thing I've done. Then you know it's got to be right. Here we go. Locust Energy Capital Building. Okay, here we go. This should be it right here. Let's see. There you go. So, and the way these locust heads are arranged on this artwork, they're just sitting there. They're not coming out of the, portal. But I've got them set up now to where they are. So now there it is, guys. I mean, you know, I mean, you're looking at absolute mind-boggling perfection from the Lord, you know, for the messenger, because he made sure I would have all the pieces. He made sure I would have everything I needed in order to encourage you not to be afraid. It's going to be scary, yeah, but we're supposed to look up. When you see this beginning to happen, look up, for your redemption draweth nigh. Wow. It's pretty heavy, isn't it? Yeah, it's pretty heavy stuff. Look at that. Covenant. Yeah. Let's see. There you go. That is definitely Isis. That is ancient Egypt. The nut, you know, the reference to nut is unarguable. The Wayland logo, it is absolutely the two intersecting V's. Let's see. Let me reduce this. You see the two V's right here? You put two V's together, you get Wayland. You see it? There it is. Right there. There it is. The one of their posters for it right there. Now, by the way, the cover for Alien Covenant, they modeled it after Rodan, the Gates of Hell. I did my own sculpture that matches Rodan, the Gates of Hell, where I turned the arm of the woman into the hand of a serpent. You see it there? It's on your screen. There's the eye of the serpent. Both her hands turn into serpents. There's the other serpent going up. There's the eye of the serpent. So there's serpents on both her hands. She's got half the face black, half white, and there's tears dripping down on her shoulder. And here's the Gates of Hell by Rodan. And this guy's arm right here becomes a serpent with the mouth open. You see right here, his hand, that's the eye of the serpent. That's the open mouth. It's a cobra. Y'all see the cobra going for her neck? Okay, so everything matches. There's no doubt about it. And you know, everything matches up. It is just too perfect. So, again, that's why I said I'd bet you $1 million. Because there's no way. There's no way that you can cover that many bases. There you go. Look at that. Y'all see how his hand is really a serpent? It's really some good artwork the way he did that. They even used the shadow to make the head of the serpent and the hood. Yeah. Y'all see it? That, okay, now listen. Dave the Wave is in the Blog Talk chat room. Dave told me that, hey, Dave, can you put the actual poster from the Covenant, Alien Covenant, in tonight's show notes? I didn't see that one, actually. Is it in there or no? Let me see. Let me see. I don't see it. You know the one with all the guys coming up? Oh, here it is. Got it. Yeah, it's in there. Yeah, there it is. Dave's got it. There it is. Look, there it is. So here it is. This is Alien Covenant. Look at them all coming up out of the pit. I mean, my goodness. Check it out. Look at that. That is some scary stuff. That's what we're about to face. That's probably what we're going to see. So I hope y'all are ready for that. Just like I told you, the people at the Red Sea, they knew they were leaving. They got to the point to where it was, this is where the rubber meets the road. This is where it happens. Hang on. I see Dave's like in the call dot. Let me, I'm going to click on this and pick up Dave's call. Dave, the Wave.
I thought I'd share something that's really interesting. Wait.
Hey. Hang on, before you do that, could you please say, oh my?
Ooh, he can do them like that too much.
He can't do it. I put him on the spot.
Oh,
too
my.
Bad.
Oh, my.
that's a big oh my is right. That's a George Takei all the way. Anyway, okay, so yeah, this is Dave the Waves on the phone. Anyway, it's just wild, isn't it?
I can do this. SpongeBob.
You can't do it, man. Anyway, holy moly, Batman. Holy guacamole and chips, Batman. This is getting crazy. Okay, Dave, what's up?
I don't have the screenshot this, but I'm looking at my random image. And on the same line where the random image is the line that is, you know, the Covenant and the Weyland-Yutani Corps logos.
Right.
Well, my random image, it's not the Ark of the Covenant, but it looks like it, but it's got the Eye of Ra on it. So it's got the two angels holding
a
Vescapisus. Which is interesting enough because if you look at the patch to the left, you know, it's got basically it's almost identical to my random images.
Right.
But what's interesting about the patch, you know, that's on their spacesuits or whatever, their uniforms.
Yeah.
You know, it says Covenant on it. Well, it's similar to the Ark of the Covenant because if you look at the Ark of the Covenant, it has the two angels looking in with the wings spread in.
Say that again. My brain's been short-circuiting. I was reading something on a screen while you were talking, trying to do it both, and I couldn't do it both. Say it again one more time. Sorry. So the
I'm gonna have to send you the random image. You can see how it lines up. But also, if you look at the patch.
Yeah. Okay. Let me go back. Let me go to the patch real quick. Okay. I've got to knock out some folders here. Let me just see which ones I can drop the hieroglyph. I can drop the snare with the anime girl with the scary tail. Okay, so click. Okay, hang on one sec. I'm almost there. Almost there. Okay. Okay. Covenant patch. Got it. USCSS Covenant. There we go. Got it. Okay.
Now, what's interesting about that, and it'll make even, you know, more of a confirmation when you see my random image. I'll put it in the show notes.
Okay.
But the patch says Covenant, but above it, it's got two angels facing each other with their wings in, which if you look at pictures of the Ark of the Covenant.
You're talking about the patch like the Ark of the Covenant. Yeah, got it.
Yeah.
I got you. Yeah, now I understand. Yeah, look at that patch, guys.
You
know,
you tie that
into
Prometheus.
Yeah. This is just crazy stuff, guys. It's just, this is mind destroying. Building better worlds. Oh, man. You know what? Yeah, there's a, I'm sure everything's significant. I'm going to look up the meaning of Weyland. How do you spell Weyland? W-Y-L-A-N-D. Y'all know what Weyland means? Who wants to know what Weyland means? Y'all know that the last kingdom of the world will be the iron mixed with the miry clay, right? Let me tell you what Weyland means. Weyland means a blacksmith with supernatural powers. You know, like, remember the Maserati commercial where they're forging iron, you know, iron mixed with the miry clay? Weyland. Yeah, there you go. Weyland. Anyway, I'm sorry. Go ahead, Dave.
I'm just adding the random image I have right now.
All right. Jess, are you going to put it on the same line or where are you going to put it?
I'll just put it at the bottom.
Okay.
Go ahead and refresh. It'll probably be in there now at the bottom.
Okay, I'll refresh. So what do you guys think? I mean, you know, let me just talk to everybody for a sec. Do y'all understand that this data is perfect? Do y'all understand that as a messenger or someone that told you, hey, I'm a messenger of the Lord God, do you understand now the severity of this information? Do you understand now that my name means exactly what I do? Yahweh has given a messenger that rings the bell and gathers the church. I haven't told y'all this yet. I don't know if I've told you live yet, but I've been given my directive on what I'm supposed to do and put on that what I'm supposed to do on that container. Oh, wow. Look at that. Okay, yeah, this is Dave's random image. Oh, my gosh. Check out Dave's random image. Look at that. Dave, you should do a side-by-side of that with the patch. Look at that. And it's got the Eye of Ra down here. Look at that. Eye of Ra. It's like the Ark of the Covenant, but inside of it, they have two intersecting circles making the Vesica Pisces. Holy moly. That's crazy. That's impossible, guys. It's the way the Lord does stuff. That's
and it just
wild.
Happens to be on the same line. The random image happens to be on the same line.
Yeah,
as the patches.
Let me show you Dave's screenshot of his page. Look at this. Watch this. So there's Dave's page. Dave screenshotted it. Look. So here's the covenant patch. Look. Right here is the covenant patch. And right here is his random image. Yeah. Covenant patch and random image. Random image and covenant patch. Wow. Oh, my brain's shot, huh? How are y'all doing? Yeah. Makes me want to go get some Chanel perfume, put on my Under Armour shirt, and go have a. I better just reel myself in now. Anyway, that's insane. That's just mind destroying. It just got very real, didn't it, folks? I mean, you know. Yeah, Dave, that's wild. Well, there it is. Okay, anything else? Dave the Wave?
Yeah. That's it.
That is it. All right. All right, man. I'll catch you after the show.
Okay. All right.
Yes, sir. Okay, bye. I'm not even sure where I'm at right now. Oh, my goodness. Okay, so anyway, guys. Oh, my gosh. Now you know why I've had my hand on my face a few times just crying, right? It just got very real, didn't it? There's no arguing with it. You know, this is... look what Dave did for you. Look at this. Look at Scooby-Doo right here. Look at the Scooby-Doo movie. Look at the Alien Covenant thing. Look. Look right here. Look right here. And look right here. Look right there. And look right there. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. That's right. It doesn't get any more horrifying than what I'm showing you guys. This is it. Louis Sota, man, that's a good question. Louis, what I did for my kids is I said, look, let me show you something. This is the most important thing you could know on planet Earth. And I took an image of the Virgin and I turned it upside down and showed them it was a dead sheep. And then I took the U.S. currency and I showed them the $20 bill. When you make a pentagram out of it, it's a Twin Tower bombing. And then I told them there's a hidden world and you've been born into a trap, a prison you can't see, taste, or smell, a prison for your mind, just like the Matrix. And unless you get freed from it, it's going to be the greatest horror you've ever seen, so you better seek it with your whole heart. Now, here's the thing. No one, and I mean nobody, comes to faith because you hounded them. Hounding them will not do a thing. You present it. You give them one of my DVDs. Say, you know what? This is the most important thing in the world. I guarantee it. And then just leave it because God will be the one that opens the door no matter what. Yeah, Carrie Amaze, they've been mocking us for a long time, but now they're busted. Do you know what convicts them, Carrie? Do y'all know what convicts them of what they're doing right now? The truth. The truth is what convicts them of what they're doing. That's why the night I got saved, the Lord told me, as my first communication was, read the tags and the clothes you're carrying. And the very first thing was 100% nylon. And then he said, turn the word nylon upside down, 100% no line. The truth is what set us free. The truth is what judges them. And the truth that is in us will judge angels. Do you understand? Yeah, that's it. End of story. Wow, that was a mind destroyer, huh? Yeah. Okay, my brain is thoroughly shot. And so at this point, I will probably seek to shut down my brain for a while, because it's probably more than I am ready to go on dealing with right now. Okay, the container. Patricia, you weren't listening. Or you must have come in late or something. The container is being set in place next Friday. I still have work to do on the container. I've been given my directive, what has to go on the container. And it is a scripture from Revelation. So, again, I will do what he tells me to do and leave the results up to him. Amen. All right. All right. All right, guys. Well, God bless, man. That was a mind destroyer, right? I mean, look at your screens. This is just mind destroying stuff. Dave, I really want to save this whole, folder tonight, Dave. We could just save it as Alien Covenant folder in the Welcome to the World of Good and Evil. Okay, let's do that. Yeah, yeah. Carrie May said, God bless, I'm exhausted. Yeah, I'm pretty exhausted too. Odell, you're welcome. God bless you too. Oh my goodness, yeah. Wow, mind destroyer, right? Okay, well, all right. Alien 2 folder, okay. Hey, yeah, okay, cool. All right, yeah. Did everybody order your new spatula? Because I'm sure y'all spatulas are getting worn out by this point. Yeah, this is some heavy stuff. Okay, God bless you guys. I love you guys in Christ. Let's pray for the lost right now. In the name of Yeshua Abba. Father, my heart's just so heavy. I know you know none of us can carry this burden very long. I wish I could save everybody. I wish I could. I pray that your will be done and that every appointment each one of us is supposed to make happens. And I know that you don't make mistakes. And I pray that, you know, each one of us are kept safe from this horror that's coming. And if there's anything you want any of us to do, please just make it obvious. All right, guys, God bless. Yeah, you know, I highly suggest that on your own time, you go over these show notes, that you sit there and you look at them and you go, wow, okay, get it in your brain, get it in your mind, get it in your spirit. So, you know, so you're prepared. So you're ready. Say, you know what? I'm not going to be afraid. It doesn't matter if it looks like the Alien movie times 10. I'm going to stand there and look up, just like the Lord says, because there's nothing else you can do anyway, is there? Right? My random image says ready now. I don't even see it. Anyway, I'll have to click back on the other ones. I may have already switched it. Oh no, it does say ready now. yeah. Alyssa said your random image says ready now. Yeah, it does. And it's on the page with all the, oh, all the fruit is ripe. Oh my God. Did you see that? The fruit is ripe. Wow, it says ready now. The fruit is ripe. It says ready now. What's really creepy is that these two bees are yellow. That's crazy. Okay, you guys, pray that I'm able to mentally endure all this without, you know, without doing the wrong thing. All right, guys, God bless you. Good night.